Em entrevistas recentes, você disse que a pandemia diminuiu o apelo eleitoral de líderes populistas de direita. Mas, ao mesmo tempo, você previu a volta de Donald Trump à Casa Branca. Como você concilia essas duas visões, aparentemente antagônicas, e qual seria o impacto para os Estados Unidos e para o mundo de uma volta do Trump à presidência dos Estados Unidos?
Well, in many ways, COVID should have been a winning issue for populists like Donald Trump, and perhaps also Jair Bolsonaro, because here was a virus that originated in China and illustrated the importance of borders. Those were two of Trump's top issues, that China was a threat and that you needed to have secure borders. Paradoxically, he failed to take advantage of the opportunity presented by the pandemic, was talked out of really closing the US borders for economic reasons, and then made the fatal mistake of putting himself at the center of the US response to the pandemic, which brought out all his worst traits, impulsiveness, ignorance of science, and by the end of 2020, an extraordinary political recklessness. And so the single reason why Donald Trump did not get re-elected in 2020 was COVID. The funny thing is that if you fast forward through the first year of Joe Biden's presidency, the pendulum of opinion has swung very rapidly back in favor of the Republican Party and Donald Trump. And I think there are two reasons for that. First, the Democrats could not magically end the pandemic. It kept going. We had the Delta wave. Even with vaccines widely available, the administration did not succeed in ending the pandemic in the way that they'd implied that they could. Because remember, they had blamed the pandemic on Trump, but they couldn't end it when he'd gone. Secondly, they made a whole series of mistakes that have really helped the Republicans. Inflation has become an issue. Immigration, again, across the southern border has become an issue. Crime has become an issue. There's been a big increase in homicide in American cities since the Black Lives Matter protests of last year. And there's also a great backlash against woke or leftist educational ideas like critical race theory, which is why the Republicans just won the governorship of Virginia. Now, Donald Trump, in many ways, is absent from our lives because he was canceled from social media back in January after the January the 6th invasion of the Capitol. At the time, Democrats thought that was great and a huge win. Oddly enough, Trump's disappearance appears to be helping Republicans because people are no longer constantly dealing with Trump's tweets. And the less they see of him, the more I think they begin to realize that there were things about the Trump administration that they liked, and there's a lot about the Biden administration they don't like. Now, 2024 is a long way away. It's a long time before he has to declare his intention to run as the Republican candidate. But I think the probability at the moment is that he will. And if he does run, it will be very hard for any other Republican to stop him. He has a huge base of support. He has a lot of money already raised. And if he runs, I think he has a very good chance of winning, because who are the Democrats going to put up against him? Kamala Harris? He'll destroy her. There won't even be a close margin the way things are going. So my sense is that Trump could very well return. It's been done before. Grover Cleveland did two non-consecutive terms as president. That's the only time it's happened. So it's possible. And if he comes back, well, think of all the ways in which the world will be turned upside down again. Can you imagine that Donald Trump would have turned up to the COP26 conference in Glasgow? Do you think Donald Trump would take it quietly if China made a move against Taiwan? We would be back to the fire and fury that we experienced through the years of his presidency. Most people don't want to think about that, including people close to Donald Trump. But I think we have to recognize that there is a significant probability that he'll be back.